Wouldn't it be great if we could recover essential resources on a massive scale from the wastewater that's flushed down the toilet and that disappears down the drain when we have a shower? We call it sewage mining, and it's our dream to be able to tap a new, undiscovered organic source which is running underground only meters away from the ground on which we walk every day. The source? Our wastewater. The potential of wastewater for a bio-based economy is not recognized today, despite the enormity of its potential. We could be extracting essential resources from wastewater. Every year, there would be 14,000 tons of phosphate, which could be used as artificial fertilizers. Or, for example, detergents for dishwashers. Or even in the food industry, phosphoric acid is present in soft drinks. The cellulose from toilet paper could be used for paper, insulation materials, and plastic car parts. There would be 140,000 tons of cellulose a year, which is the equivalent of 3 billion plastic cups. The algae that grows on our wastewater could be used for food and animal feed, as well as in the cosmetics industry. Alginates, 40,000 tons a year, could be used to thicken ink and sauces. Nitrogen is needed for ammonia compounds, which in turn are necessary for artificial fertilizers. From CO2, one can make calcium carbonate, which is used to make gypsum plaster or fertilizers for the greenhouse industry. And CO2 is what makes the bubbles in soda drinks. Syngas is a semi-finished product of chemicals, which could be used for production of glues, plastics, paints, and cosmetics. Sulfur could be used for fertilizers or as an additive to rubber. Sulfates are used in gypsum plaster and as a raw material in the household goods industry. And what about the water itself? We could use it in industry as process and cooling water, or for irrigation in agricultural and greenhouse industries. The yearly production by water authorities in the Netherlands would be 2,000 billion liters. And what's so great about it all is that wastewater is everywhere. The concept can be applied from Africa to Alaska. All our fresh water, all the urine, feces and toilet paper, worldwide. What a raw materials yield that would be. And it would reduce the global ecological footprint substantially. Now, who wouldn't want to dream about that?